Hello friends, in this video we are going to talk about k-nearest neighbor algorithm. To start with, the k-nearest neighbor algorithm, normally just called KNN, is a classification algorithm. And classification is determining what group something belongs in. This could be what species an insect is in, type of tumor, etc. In order for KNN to work, you need some examples with correct group. This is used to predict future groups, that is, in what group the future data is in. We normally refer to it as reference data. That means we need some reference data for KNN algorithm. Now, for the data record that needs to be classified, it computes the distance between the data record and all of the reference data records. Then it looks at the k closest data records in the reference data. For example, if you set k equal to 5, then it will look at 5 closest records in the reference data. Whatever is the majority class in this group of k data records, it is the predicted class of algorithm. Let's say that we want to create a program that will predict if someone likes cricket, football, or neither any one of them. For this example, we need to assume that a person cannot like both cricket and football. So here we are going to talk about KNN algorithm with a very simple example. So this is what the data I have. Using this example, we are going to see how KNN actually works. Now here we think that we can predict the classification of sport based upon age and gender. So if you look at this data, what I have is name, age, gender and sport. For example, Ajay with the age 32, gender is male, he likes the sport called as football. Similarly for Mark, Sara, Zaira, Sachin, Rahul and so on. Now, as we needed data with correct classification, so we survey some people and this is what we have. So we will assume that this is the data we got after surveying. So to proceed with the prediction of KNN, what we can do here is, as we have data with correct classification, KNN can make predictions. Let's say that I want KNN to predict what class of sport for a person named Angelina is. For example, I want to predict what class of sport the person with the name Angelina can be put into. So what we will assume that Angelina is female with the age of 5. We want to find out what class of sport she belongs to. So we can efficiently use KNN algorithm here to know that or to classify that. As earlier I said that KNN is a classification algorithm, so KNN can be used efficiently to find out where the person with the name Angelina with the age of 5 and gender as female belongs to, whether she belongs to the group of people who like football or cricket or neither any one of them. So let's see how this can be done with the help of KNN algorithm here. Let's say that I want KNN to predict class of the sport for Angelina. Okay, Angelina is a female with the age 5. Let's say we set the value of k equal to 3. So in this KNN, what I will assume is I will set k equal to 3. Okay. Sum of our data is numeric. If you look, for example, age, this is numeric. And other is discrete, like gender. So first of all, what we need to do is we need to convert discrete data to numeric. So let's say that for male, we will identify male as 0 and for female we will use 1. So this is how you can convert the discrete data into numeric. Now we have all numeric numbers. So after converting that data into numeric, now we can proceed with KNN algorithm. Now what KNN algorithm is going to do is, KNN algorithm is going to find out the distance of Angelina from each point of the reference data. So we will try to find out the distance of Angelina from Ajay, then Mark, Sarah, Zaira, Sachin, and so on. So how to do this? Let's check. To find out the distance, KNN algorithm makes use of some distance equations. For example, here we will make use of a distance equation, which is under root of x1 minus x2 whole square plus y1 minus y2 whole square. So we are going to find out the distance of Angelina from every point in the reference data using Euclidean distance. So this is called as Euclidean distance. You can go with other distances also. You can use other distances like Manhattan distance or Minkowski distance and etc. So there are other ways also to calculate the distances. Distance of the here in our case, distance of Angelina from all other points from the reference data. So as we have two pieces of data, that is age and gender, if you look at this example, we have two pieces of data, age and gender. We are going to take the differences of those and square it and add up together. If there were four pieces or five pieces of data about each sport, we would have just added those continuously like this. Right? Age, this is for age, this is for gender. And if you would have other pieces of data, you would have added those continuously like this. So we are going to use the distance called as Euclidean distance in this example. So what we have is, we have the reference data and we have assumed that for male we are using 0. So if you go and if you check that particular example, I will show you the how to calculate the distance between Angelina and any one point. For example, the first person in the reference data is Ajay. If you look at this one, the first person in the reference data is Ajay with the age 32 and he is a male. So we can compute the distance between Angelina and Ajay as, by using this particular equation, that is the equation of Euclidean distance, we can compute the distance between Ajay and Angelina by using this particular equation. So how? Let's check. The first person name is Ajay. He is a male and his age is 32. If I want to apply Euclidean distance, so same formula I can use. So under root of now Angelina's age is 5 and Ajay's age is 32. So what I can do is, for the first piece of information, under root of 5 minus 32 whole square, okay, and then as Angelina is a female and for female we are using 1, so the second piece of information is 1 minus, and for Ajay he is a male, so it will be 1 minus 0. So this will be for age and this will be for gender. So if you calculate this particular distance, so it comes out to be under root of, so 729 plus 1, so it comes out to be 27.02. So this is a distance between Angelina and Ajay, that is the distance of Angelina from one of the reference points from the reference data. So this is how you can calculate the distances between Angelina and all the other remaining people. So once we calculate all the distances, what we get is this particular table. So as we have seen how to calculate the distance between Angelina and Ajay, so distance between Angelina and Ajay is 27.0. So you can look at this particular field distance. So by following the same way, the distance between Angelina and other people is calculated. For example, the distance between Mark, whose age is 40, who is a male, is 35.01, and Mark likes neither cricket nor football. Similarly, distance between Sarah and Angelina is 11. Distance between Zaira and Angelina is 9, and so on. So this is what we got after calculating the distances between Angelina and all the other people. Okay. Now after this, once we have got these distances, Now, earlier as we decided that k is set to 3. The value of k we set is 3. So, in our case, the value of k is 3. So, we look for 3 closest records to Angelina. If you look at this particular table, you will find out that the 3 closest records to Angelina, if we see the distances, are this one. Angelina and Zaira, the distance, Zaira's distance is 9, then Smith's distance is 10 and Michael's distance is 10.05. So these are the 3 closest records to Angelina if you try and check from this particular distance field. So we got three distances. So what are those? So the first one is Zaira's distance is 9 and then Smith's distance is 10 and the third one is Michael's distance is 10.5. So we can check and say that these are the 3 closest neighbor to Angelina from reference data. Now look at the classification of these 3 nearest neighbors. If you look at the classification of these three nearest neighbors, for example Zaira, so Zaira likes cricket, Smith likes cricket and Michael likes football. So Zaira likes cricket, Smith also likes cricket and Michael likes football. So if you look at the classification which is given in this table, which is in the reference data, I have written that classification here: cricket, cricket and football. Now since the class of cricket, if you check, is the most common among these nearest neighbors, then CNN will predict that Angelina will be in the class of people who like the sport called as cricket. So that's how the KNN algorithm works to classify data based upon reference data that already knows what group or class of data belongs to. So this is what we got with the help of KNN algorithm. The question was, in which class Angelina should be put into? Whether she must be put into the class of people who likes football, neither or cricket. So in our case, using KNN algorithm and using k equal to 3, we can say that Angelina can be put into the group of people who like cricket. So that's it, friends. That's all about KNN algorithm. Thank you very much.